Hey folks, hi, welcome to another episode of my vlog. Today I'm taking you on a tour of my neighborhood, and for starters, I want to show you what it looks like through my eyes.
Nera di mala sorte, che ammazza e passa oltre. Nera come la sfortuna che si fa la tana dove non c'è luna, luna. Nera di falde amare, che passano le bare. Ma la moglie di Anselmo non lo deve sapere, che è venuta per me, è arrivata da un'ora, e l'amore all'amore come solo argomento, il tumulto del cielo ha sbagliato un momento. Acqua che non si aspetta, altro che benedetta. Acqua che porta male, sale dalle scale, sale senza sale, sale. Acqua che spacca il monte, che affonda e terra e ponte.
I hope you all appreciated that. And so now I'm going to go a little bit more in depth and show you all the stores and operations taking place on my street in the neighborhood here in Via Fondazza. And show you how the community really functions here. And then I'm going to compare it to Kingwood. And then show you, I guess, compare the size and then compare the population density and the amount of stores and stuff there. And I think it's kind of interesting to take a look at that. First off, Bologna is a city and Kingwood is a suburb. So they're two very different places, with Kingwood having about 60,000 people and Bologna having about 300,000 people. So there's going to be a lot more stores and things and business in Bologna. But, however, I find it interesting that the historic center of Bologna is about the same size or slightly smaller than maybe a third of Kingwood, the Kingwood Loop, the Kingwood Drive, Woodland Hills, North Park, and Muslake Houston Square. So that's kind of, I found that kind of weird. And then I'm going to show you how just my street, little neighborhood here, has almost as much business as all of Kingwood. So, what's going on here in Europe?
Now here's Via Fondazza, tobacco shop, restoration store, university building, first barber shop, second barber shop, woman's hair salon, first grocery store, second grocery store, third grocery store, fourth a chain grocery store, five a dirty grocery store, child's clothing store, another clothing store, more adult clothing store, newspaper stand, school supply store, frames, my house, the sign pointed at the museum at my house, a pizza place, another pizza place, a plumber, a copy store, a local bookstore, a carpet place, a kebab store, a cinema, a bakery, cafe, second cafe, a third cafe, a bike shop, a carpenter's, a French restaurant, an Italian restaurant, a pharmacy, an herb pharmacy, a church, a bank, a post office that works as a bank, a jewelry store, and a place to get your boat license.
The coolest thing about living on a street this densely, I guess you could say, occupied by businesses and people, is that you can get anything you want just outside your front door. If I want to get a haircut, I step outside. If I say I try to make something, I'm cooking something, and I forget, oh no, I need an onion, I can run downstairs and pick up an onion. If I get hungry, there's bananas. There's anything. There's Coke and stuff. There's if I want to go out, there's two bars right outside, and so I can go drink there. I could pick up a sandwich at one of those bars too. There's a ton of stuff here. It's basically anything you want is at your fingertips right here. You don't have to go very far for anything outside of your little community. And I think most of y'all that are much older than me probably experienced a life that was like that. But me, I've never ever experienced anything like this, except for maybe on a university. And a university, though, campus is an artificial kind of community. So it's different. I've got old people, young people. I see kids walking around, and I see immigrants and stuff. It's a good mix of people, and it's cool to recognize people on the street. I mean, I've never been inside the certain stores, and I still recognize the people, and we kind of nod and say hi to each other. And I think that's really cool. And I don't know, suburbs are a very different story. The point of a suburb is to have a lot of land, and I think Kingwood is beautiful with its trees, makes like a lot of space. But I would still appreciate being able to at least walk to a grocery store. So, I don't know, something to think about, and I think it'll be something that we'll be hearing a lot about in the next 10 to 20 years. So, I hope you enjoyed seeing my neighborhood, and I will invite you back again in one of the next videos. Alright, have a great week. Love you guys.